welcome back to my channel. This is Cleopatra on the move, and today I'm doing a skincare haul. So I saw many YouTubers buying Ofia Style and decided to try it out. I kept watching so many videos to see what the best sellers are and to get them all. I spent $150 on this huge haul, so come along and see what I got and if it was worth it or not. Ordered is the Laneige lip sleeping mask. I got it in small size, and if I like it, I will get the big one, because honestly it was very expensive. This small container was for $3.35. You're supposed to apply it on your lips overnight, and on the next day you wake up with very smooth lips. I also got this acne pimple master patches from the brand called Cozy RX. It's a one sheet with 24 patches in three different sizes. It has very good reviews, and you put it on your pimple and overnight or during the day if you're staying at home, and it should magically disappear the next day because it removes all the impurities and oils on your skin. Then the next product that I also ordered is this green tea eye gel patches. The best thing about them is that they are paraben free, and this is always a plus in any skincare product. I will be mainly using these on days where I didn't sleep enough to repuff my eyes, but they recommend using it every day and to integrate it into your skincare routine. This container with 60 patches is sold for $16.83. The next products that I picked up and I was very interested in are the Dr. Drugs products, because they are recommended by everyone, but they are very expensive. So I thought I will give it a try and see what all the hype is about. So the first item or product that I picked up from Dr. Drugs are the Ceramidine face masks. It's a sheet of 5 for $21. Then the next product I also ordered from Dr. Drugs is the Rubber Moisturizing Hyaluronic Acid mask. It's only one mask and sold for $11, so it's very expensive. I hope I don't like it, because I will be in trouble, because $11 for just one mask is really a lot. It contains of the rubber mask and the ampoule to put it on the mask. Then the last product I got from Dr. Drugs is the Shake and Shot mask. They come in a cup to mix the mask ingredients and put them on your face. This one was around $10. If you want to see a Dr. Drugs product reviews, please let me know down below. I also picked some other sheet masks. Each was almost $3. The first one was the Pure Snail Mask for Skin Smoothing from the brand called Tusu Wong. And then from a brand called Holika Holika, a Milky Jelly Strawberry Mask. I'm excited to try this. Another also jelly mask from the brand called With Face. And I got another one from my favorite brand, The Face Shop, from the Solution line, also for moisturization. The last sheet mask that I got is from the brand BT21. This one is not a one sheet mask, but more of the patches that you put on your face. They look so cute, so I wanted to try them, but I want to see if they are really effective or not. This is a set of 7, so 7 sheets with each patches, like around 6 patches each sheet. This one was for $7. The next item I also got is this Low PhD Good Morning Cleanser. This one was recommended almost by everyone. It's from the brand Cozy RX, and it was for $11. You have to use this daily. It leaves your skin very refreshed and free of acne. So I'm excited to try this one out. Then I got the Ginseng Serum. It was for $25, so pretty expensive, but it should be worth it. Ginseng is known to prevent wrinkles and protect against sun damage. Then I also got this Nair Repair Eye Cream from a brand called Mizen. This one was for $13. It's supposed to be the best eye cream out there, with its slight consistency that moisturizes under the eyes and removes the dark circles. I also found this Pink Raccoon Cheek Sheets. The whole idea of cheek sheets are new to me, so I wanted to try it. It looks so cute. Let's see if this is effective or not. This one was for $3 also. It's just one sheet with 2 cheek patches. And then everyone was saying that the Korean SPF is something else, so I picked up the Biore UV SPF 50. This was for around $10. I'm planning to use this every day I go out. It should have a light consistency, so you can use it under your makeup. The next items that I ordered are some Korean hand creams. They had very good reviews. The first one is from the Face Shop brand. It looks like a cactus, very cute to put as decoration, but also the cream itself had very good reviews. It has light smell and light consistency and moisturizes very good. The other one is from the brand Tony Mori. Both hand creams are around $7. This also had good reviews, and I will be doing hand cream review video. So stay tuned and subscribe to my channel to see this video. So the last two items that I ordered are the Green Level Calming Toner by a brand called Purito. It's for sensitive skin and leaves your skin moisturized and refreshed. This one was for $16. And the other product is a face cream by a brand called Rukujun. This one is not Korean but Japanese. It has very good reviews. And this one was for $18 for hydration for sensitive skin. So I'm excited to try all the products that I got and give you guys reviews. Let me know if you need a specific review. And thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like my video. Until next video and next move. Bye.